How's it going, guys? Welcome to the 2021 LA Auto Show. Unfortunately, it was canceled for 2020, so I'm very excited to be back, starting off at the Toyota booth. Let's take a look at the new GR86, which I've actually never seen before in person. 2.4 liter four cylinder, making 228 horsepower. It's actually got a limited slip rear differential, which is awesome. And you can get it with a 6-speed manual transmission. Pretty cool car for the money, and check this out. Unfortunately, it's just a concept, but they unveiled this at SEMA, the Sport Top Supra, which is basically a Targa Top version of the Toyota Supra. I think it suits the car so well. What do you guys think? I really wish they'd make this. Cool opportunity to see the new Nissan Z in person, and I have to say, particularly in this blue, it looks amazing. I love the reminiscence of the 300ZX in the rear taillights, as well as this Kasana line right there. Coming around to the interior, one of the coolest parts about the new Z is the fact that you can get it in a manual, which is a huge downside to the Toyota Supra. I think they did a really good job with the interior. 3-liter twin turbocharged six cylinder, 400 horsepower, 350 pound feet of torque. I can't wait to drive one of these. Land Rover just dropped the new Range Rover, and it is absolutely breathtaking inside and out. Just get a load of the amenities in the rear seat of this vehicle. Two beautiful displays in the back, reclining rear seats. I love that chevron accent right there. Taking a look at another spec Range Rover, I am in love with the way this new car looks. The interior, this one's quite different, still absolutely gorgeous. Let's check out the rear seat area. Well, guys, one of the cars I was most excited to see at the LA Auto Show was the new Z06. Let's go ahead and do a little walk around. 670 horsepower, 8,600 RPM, flat plane crank V8. Honestly, in person, this thing looks extremely aggressive. This has the Z07 package on it, which comes with a host of carbon fiber upgrades, like that massive rear wing. It's also got the optional carbon fiber wheels, which is unbelievable. I will say, if you don't get the Z07 package, look how similar the Z06 looks to the Stingray over there. When you're walking up from afar, it's actually almost impossible to tell the difference. Obviously, there's some subtle tweaks, but if you're gonna get the new Z06, you have to opt for that aero package. I do have to say, the Z06 really does have some supercar rivaling looks, and with its new mid-engine layout and that unbelievable sounding V8, this really is an epic sports car. Big focus on electric cars this year at the LA Auto Show. This Hyundai Ioniq 5 actually looks really cool. And if we walk over here, they've just released the 7 concept. Man, I hope they produce something that actually looks like this. That is a really good looking front end. Check out the interior. Check out this interior. Wow. The car actually looks badass. I love the rectangular headlights, and these wheels almost look like they're aftermarket rotiforms. Fisker has come out with an all-electric SUV dubbed the Ocean with 300 miles of range, and apparently this is one of 5 SUVs they plan on making by 2025. Honestly think it looks pretty good. Fisker has always done a phenomenal job with their design language. How's this for something rare you don't see every day? The Aston Martin Signet. These things were crazy expensive when they were new for essentially a fancy version of a smart car, but there's something undeniably cool about this. As usual, Galpin Autosports has a really cool setup in the basement here at the auto show. Check out this absolutely gorgeous DBS Superleggera, a whole lineup of Astons. That DBX actually looks really nice in that light blue. Coming over to a beautiful GT500. And then a Golf livery Ford GT. This Pantera is pretty cool. White on white with white wheels. Take a look at the interior. This car reminds me of a Countach in many, many ways. Really cool display of Porsches as well. Check this thing out. Cobera C300, an all-electric version of an old Shelby Cobra, which it's kind of the exact opposite of the point of a Cobra, but also cool nonetheless. Nice interior work as well. Take a look under the hood. 600 horsepower, 0 to 60 in 2.7 seconds. And here it is, guys, the new Cayman GT4 RS. Edison Future Truck. I have never heard of this, but it looks really cool.
Check out the interior. I dig the ambient lighting too.
They've got a panel van version too, which kind of looks like the ultimate hearse. It's almost scary. We finally made it to Porsche, the area I've been most excited about, and their display does not disappoint. I wish that my camera could capture how unbelievably sexy and aggressive the Mission R looks in person, but seriously, you guys have to see this in person to believe how cool it looks. All electric concept race car, 1,073 horsepower, 0 to 60 in 2.5 seconds, and apparently, by 2025, they're actually going to come out with a production version to some degree of this car. But literally every single angle is a work of art on the Mission R. I love that rear taillight. Look at the rear diffuser, the wing itself. Wow, what I would do for one of these. All right, guys, here it is. The car I'm most excited about at the entire show, the all-new Porsche Cayman GT4 RS. I've long awaited them to make an RS version of the Cayman as it's such a brilliant car right out of the box. But now it's lighter, more powerful. The GT4 RS is actually powered by the new flat six that comes in the brand new GT3. It makes 493 horsepower, 10 less than the GT3, which isn't actually a marketing reasoning. It's because the exhaust is actually longer on this car, so it loses a bit of power. 331 pound-feet of torque. It's got 79 horsepower more than the normal GT4. And look at all the carbon fiber and aero bits throughout the car. You can actually get it with a Y-Soc package now, dropping the curb weight down to 3,220 pounds. It's 1.2 inches lower than the GT4, riding on new Bilstein shocks. Let's go ahead and take a look at the interior. Wow. I am in love with the Alcantara inserts on these Y-Soc bucket seats. Now notice, while this looks like a manual transmission, because it's an RS car, you can only get it with a PDK, which is really the only downfall of this car. Porsche claims they've done some sound tuning to the side intakes to route more sound into the cabin in what Porsche also claims to be the most intense sounding GT car they have made to date. Base price is $143,000. We should start seeing them in summer of 2022, but rest assured, they will likely be $50,000+ over sticker. I certainly want one. Look how beautiful these wheels are. The louvered fenders, like the 3RS and 2RS, knock-a-ducks in the hood. Wow. Another design element I absolutely love is the underhung wing. Looks so cool. That split tailpipe. Now, Porsche also released the GT4 RS Club Sport. So this is a track-only version of the GT4 RS, making 500 horsepower. Take a look, fully stripped out interior. This thing looks absolutely wicked. The Cayenne Turbo GT is also awesome, a 631 horsepower SUV that does 0 to 60 in 3.1 seconds and currently holds the record for fastest Nürburgring lap time of any SUV. Absolutely gorgeous interior in here too. I love how race inspired it feels with that Alcantara inserts, Alcantara on the shift lever, as well as these handles here. Porsche also unveiled the Taycan GTS Sport Turismo, which is like the Cross Turismo, only they've gotten rid of the cladding and it's a little bit classier and sexier. I absolutely love the design of this. I mean, it makes a Panamera look absolutely terrible by comparison. The GTS slots between the 4S and the Turbo with horsepower in between the two. I am in love with this estate styling. Check out all of the Alcantara inside of the GTS. The seats are almost 100% Alcantara. And look at that wheel with the gorgeous satin carbon fiber. Check this out, the Turbo S Cross Turismo. These wheels are absolutely insane. I've never seen a design like that from Porsche before, and I absolutely love it. I give some love to this beautiful Carrera RS, and next to it, the new GT3. All right, I gotta give Subaru some serious credit for going absolutely over the top with their display. I mean, they have a tunnel, they have a bridge that you can walk over. Literally a jungle in here, that is wild. Subaru's all new electric SUV, the Solterra. Ram with a pretty crazy display. First time seeing the newly redesigned WRX in person.
I do have to say, in person, it does look a lot better than pictures, but I think I'm still a fan of the previous generation more than this redesign. Now this is much better looking. This concept is epic. The Ford F-100 concept, retro design, but it's fully electric. I really hope they make something like this in the future. And check out how gorgeous that Ford GT is. So the 2021 Heritage Edition. Wow, this slammed Mach-E on wheels actually looks really good. How's this for something unique? A new Ford Maverick build. Really cool wheels. Here's an SUV I've been wanting to check out for a while now, the Grand Wagoneer. And honestly, it's pretty opulent inside and out, particularly for the price. $104,000. Look at all of the chrome trim, and it is absolutely enormous. Well, for some reason, that one was locked, so we'll move over to this Grand Wagoneer. Hop in the rear seat environment. Automatic floorboard comes down to make it easy to get in. Look at that. There is so much space in here. I love the quilted leather. Got a display here, two displays there. Let's hop on into the front seat environment. Honestly, they did such a good job with this car. Macintosh sound system. Wow. New Grand Cherokee design is pretty cool as well. Really aggressive front bumper, particularly the lower portion of the fascia. What do you guys think? Pretty cool display over at Dodge. Now check this out. This is the Challenger Drag Pack. This car, obviously not street legal, but comes from the factory, capable of running a 7-second quarter mile. Check it out. We got a parachute on the back, wheelie bars. Well, guys, I feel like this would be a fun place to end today's vlog up here on this overlook. I hope you guys enjoyed a brief tour of the LA Auto Show, particularly that Porsche exhibit. That was insane. Loving the GT4 RS. Hopefully can drive one sometime in the future. Hope you guys enjoyed today's video. Like always, please browse the channel and subscribe. Look forward to seeing you next video.